Good afternoon students. Today we will continue the topic of complex numbers and quadratic equation. In previous lecture we have done exercise 5.2 problems which is based on converting the complex numbers into polar form, right? See that you have done as homework, but I will explain those two questions which are a little bit not like tough questions, so a little bit different when compared to remaining questions. So I will explain once. If you have already done, okay, skip this to the next concept. So the question is, convert the complex number into polar form. So the given complex number -1 -i, is it in proper polar form? Is it in proper complex number? First of all, actually we consider z is equal to x plus iy as complex number form, right? X plus I into y. If we compare with x plus iy, what do you get? X value, x is equal to -1. What was the value of y? Y also -1. If you observe, x also -1, y also -1. In two dimensional plane or nothing but in Argand plane, when we'll get minus and minus, in which quadrant? Third quadrant, we'll get minus and minus. In third quadrant, if we get minus and minus, what we need to take? If it is first quadrant, theta. Second quadrant, pi minus theta. Fourth quadrant, minus theta. Third quadrant, we need to take theta minus pi, we need to take. Now, first of all, to find that polar form, what do you mean by polar form? Polar form is z is equal to r into cos theta plus I sine theta. So, you need to remember this formula. Z is equal to r into cos theta plus I sine theta. Where r represents modulus of a given complex number. Theta means an argument. Argument means that theta should be lies between minus 180 degrees to equal to 180 degrees. So first of all, we will find r in order to bring that polar form. So we know that r is equal to square root of x square plus y square. Square root of x square minus 1 whole square is 1 plus 1, which is equal to square root 2. So that is the value of r. To find that theta, nothing but argument. We know tan theta is equal to y by x. According to that previous concept, tan theta is equal to y by x. Tan theta is equal to y by x. What is y here? Y is -1, x is -1. -1 by -1, which gives 1. So therefore, tan theta is equal to what we got? Tan pi by 4. Nothing but 1 in terms of tan is tan 45 degrees. But can we consider theta is equal to pi by 4? Can we consider? Here we got tan theta is equal to tan pi by 4, theta is equal to pi by 4. Can we consider this pi by 4? No, we should not take. Why? Because as that complex number represents, it is in third quadrant. Third quadrant is what we need to do? Theta minus pi. What is theta here? Theta is pi by 4. Pi by 4 minus pi we need to do. So tan of pi by 4 minus pi, which is tan, see this is 4 pi minus 3 pi by 4. So tan theta is equal to minus 3 pi by 4. Nothing but theta equal to minus 3 pi by 4. Right, like that you need to consider. Whatever we get theta, that's not the final thing. Based on the complex number, in which quadrant it is there, that we need to take. For example, if the given complex number is in first quadrant, both are plus, then pi by 4 only we need to consider. Why? Because that is in between 0 to 90 degrees, 45 only we need to consider. For example, if it is in second quadrant, we got pi by 4, then pi minus pi by 4 we need to do. Since it is in third quadrant, theta minus pi we need to do. If it is in fourth quadrant means what? X value positive, y value negative. If it is like that, pi by 4 we got, but what we should consider? We should consider minus pi by 4, like that we need to do. Therefore required polar form is equal to z is equal to r into what is r? Root 2 into cos minus 3 pi by 4 plus I into sin minus 3 pi by 4. So this is our final answer. See, this is very simple, right? So I got, by this you will get 3 marks question. Very easy to do. Next, sixth question from the same exercise 5.2. Converting complex number into polar form. Maximum of your students you have done this problem. But some may have doubt, but you did not ask that, but I will explain this. See, is minus 3 is a complex number or real number? -3 is an integer, negative integer, and also real number, and also a complex number. Why is it a integer and also real number? Now, why it is a complex number? Complex number means x plus i y form, but it is simply it is -3. How we can write in terms of complex number? First of all, compare the given complex number. Given complex number with x plus i y, nothing but this 3. How we can write -3 plus 0 into i? We can write, right? That means here what is x value? X value -3, y value 0. Any real number, remember, any real number we can convert in terms of complex number, that is x plus i y form or a plus i b form. Here x value is nothing but real part value, y value is nothing but imaginary part. So here no imaginary part value, so that's why that y value is nothing but 0. So here we got x value and y value. So then we can find easily r value. What is r value? X square plus y square, right? See, what is x square? -3 whole square is 9, plus y square is 0. So which means square root of 9 is 3. We should not take plus or minus 3. Why? Because r is nothing but modulus, and also r is radius. What is this r represents? Distance from pole to the complex number, right? So distance means always it should be positive. So we have to consider only 3. Next, we need to find theta. To find theta, tan theta is equal to y by x. Tan theta is equal to what is y value? 0 by -3. So tan theta is equal to what? Tan 0. Tan theta is equal to tan 0. But should can we consider theta as 0? No, we cannot consider blindly. How we can consider? Based on these quadrants. Based on these quadrants, we need to consider the theta value. If you observe this, -3 plus 0 i, -3 in which quadrant or where it will lies? On negative x axis. The point is -3, 0, right? So it will lies on negative x axis. Negative x axis means what? Angle is what? 180 degrees. So directly you can write tan theta is equal to tan pi, right? Otherwise pi minus theta, it belongs to second angle, right? So pi minus theta is nothing but pi minus 0, will get pi. So therefore tan theta is equal to tan pi. Therefore, theta is equal to pi. So now we got r value and also theta value. Therefore, required polar form. Required polar form is equal to z is equal to r means how much you got? 3 into cos pi plus I sin pi. So these are the questions which belongs to exercise 5.2. That is based on converting complex number into polar form. One thing you remember, if they are given directly in terms of polar form, we will get x value and y value. If we get x value, remaining all we can find. If they did not given in terms of a proper complex form, we need to convert in terms of complex number, then we will get x value. If they given like p by q forms, like for example 1 plus i by 1 minus i, so this they are given z is equal to and convert into polar form. How to do? First of all, we need to convert this given complex number into proper form or general form, nothing but x plus i. Whenever in the p by q form, in the denominator I is there, then what you need to do is rationalize 1 plus i by 1 plus i. 1 minus i means 1 plus i by 1 plus i. If it is 1 plus i means 1 minus i by 1 minus i. For example, if we are having root 2, if we are having root 2, z is equal to 1 plus i by root 2, then how we can convert this number into proper form? This we can write as 1 by root 2 plus I into 1 by root 2. Like that also we can write, right? Then only this is the, then this will be the x value, this will be the y value, right? So pause the video to note it down. Students, now we will discuss how to find roots of quadratic equations which gives the discriminant less than 0. So we know the actual formula of how to find roots of quadratic equation. For example, you see, general quadratic equation form I will write, that is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, right? This is a general form of a quadratic equation. Why quadratic? Means that highest degree here or power here is 2, and that too when it comes to this ax square plus bx plus c, a comma b comma c are real constants, and a shouldn't be equal to 0. A should not be equal to 0. Why? Because if a equal to 0, it will become linear equation, not quadratic, right? May b can be equal to 0, c can be equal to 0 sometimes, but a should not be equal to 0. This is the condition for a quadratic equation. Now from this quadratic equation, how to find roots? To find roots, what is the formula we have generally? See, what we have learned up to now is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, right? So in this formula, what we need to substitute is here b value we need to substitute, a value, c value, these values if we substitute, you will get two values. Quadratic means two values we should get. Where we will get two? This is only one formula, na? One we should consider plus b, another one we should consider minus. If we split like that, we will get two roots. Now here what we consider is b square minus 4ac as discriminant. We know that b square minus 4ac greater than 0 condition, b square minus 4ac equal to 0 condition, b square minus 4ac less than 0 condition. So if b square minus 4ac equal to 0, then roots are what? Then roots are real and equal. Roots are real and equal. But when it comes to b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, then what are the roots? Roots are real but unequal. But what when it comes to b square minus 4ac less than 0, those are roots are imaginary and unequal. Now to find b square minus 4ac greater than 0 and b square minus 4ac equal to 0, if we use this formula, it will be enough. To find b square minus 4ac less than 0, which gives roots are imaginary and unequal, we need to use this formula only, but a slight difference in this formula. Now the same formula where x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. The same formula we will write it as minus b plus or minus square root of 4ac minus b square into I by 2a. Did you understand this? This b square minus 4ac we can write it as 4ac minus b square into I. Why? Because as it will become negative, when in these conditions, as if it is negative, that negative we will write it as I outside. So then it will become 4ac minus b square into I. See, let us solve some of the questions, then you can understand how to simplify and what may be the roots when come to b square minus 4ac less than 0. See, for example, if the question is like x square plus 3 equal to 0, x square plus 3 is equal to 0, or if the question is x square minus 3 equal to 0, x square equal to 3, x equal to plus or minus square root of 3, right? But what about if x square plus 3 equal to 0, x square equal to minus 3, x is equal to plus or minus square root of minus 3. Is that a square root of minus 3, did we have any value? No. But by introducing that iota, we can write this as x is equal to plus or minus square root of 3 into I. Right or not? Why? Because square root of minus 3, square root of minus 3 can write as square root of minus 1 into square root of 3. So that square root of minus 1 is nothing but I value, nothing but iota. Therefore, if x square plus 3 is equal to 0, then x values are plus or minus root 3 into I. So if you want, you can check here by substituting in the place of x. Substitute plus root 3a, substitute here plus root 3a whole square plus 3 equal to 0. So root 3 whole square is 3, I square value minus 1 plus 3 equal to 0, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3, minus 3 plus 3 is equal to 0. So therefore, so like this we need to write roots. Whenever we get negative, that negative minus 1 we need to bring it outside, that we need to write it as I is nothing but iota, which represents square root of minus 1. See, let us simplify some of the problems of exercise 5.3, which is based on only finding roots of a quadratic equation. But when it comes to this exercise 5.3, see, all quadratic equations which gives b square minus 4ac less than 0 only. Why? Because this chapter itself complex number, right? So according to that only they have given all the equations which gives b square minus 4ac less than 0. In that case, which formula you need to use? Minus b plus or minus square root of 4ac minus b square into I by 2a. So let us solve the question. Second question. 2x square plus x plus 1 equal to 0. 2x square plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. See, from this quadratic equation, first of all, compare the given quadratic equation with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Then you will get abc values, right? If you know abc values, directly you can substitute in that formula. Therefore, a is equal to 2, b is equal to 1, and c is equal to 1. If you do b square minus 4ac in this rough side, b square is 1 minus 4 into a is 2 into 1. 1 minus 8 is nothing but minus 7. Minus 7 is nothing but less than 0. Less than 0 means which formula you need to use? This formula. Therefore, x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of 4ac minus b square into I divided by 2a. So substitute those values, b value, this is minus 1 plus or minus square root of 4ac, 4 into a value 2, c value 1, minus b square is 1 square, 1 in 1, outside we need to write I, not inside that root, divided by 2a, 2 to 4. So this value is minus 1 plus or minus square root of 4 to the 8, 8 minus 1 is square root of 7 into I divided by 4. This is what? The solution. Therefore, solution of x is equal to minus 1 plus or minus square root of 7 into I by 4. Right? So like this we need to simplify the quadratic equations, and nothing but solving the equations is nothing but finding the x values. See, I'm telling in this chapter you are going to get 2-3 marks questions. What? 2-3 marks questions. 1-3 marks question is based on polar form, converting complex number into polar form, that is fixed model. What may be the question? But model is converting complex number into polar form. Another question is finding roots of quadratic equation. See, as you know that how much easy it is, just finding that, comparing the a value, b value, c value, substitute in that formula which gives 3 marks. See how much easy it is. So pause video to note it down. Next, and there are two problems of exercise 5.3, which are also we need to solve the equation. See, question about how they will give means solve the equation. See, solving the equation is nothing but what? Finding the x value. Finding the x value from the quadratic equation means what? Finding the roots itself. So therefore, see, these two problems I'll do, remaining problems you need to do for assignment. See, first of all, compare the given equation. Compare the given equation with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Right? Then what is the a value? A is equal to root 2, b is equal to 1, c is equal to root 2. So we know the formula. Roots of quadratic equation. What is roots of quadratic equation formula? That x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of 4ac minus b square into I by 2a. See, simply substitute those values. Minus b. So minus 1 plus or minus square root of 4ac. 4 into a value root 2. C value also root 2. Minus b square. What is b square value? 1 square 1 into I divided by 2a. Nothing but 2 root 2. Then simplify this, minus 1 plus or minus square root of root 2 into root 2 is 2, 4 2 is 8, 8 minus 1 is 7 into I by 2 root 2. See how simple it is. See, so this carries 3 marks, right? Very easy questions, right? Next, same. Compare the given equation. Compare the given equation with ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Then what will be the a value? A value 1. B value how much? B value is 1. C value how much? C value is 1 by root 2. See, like this also you can take a value 1, b value 1, c value 1 by root 2. Or another way is also there. Like that is taking LCM. Root 2 is LCM. So root 2 x square plus root 2 x plus 1 by root 2 equal to 0. So root 2 if sent to right hand side, it will become root 2 x square plus root 2 x plus 1 equal to 0. See, both equations are same. If you compare this to this one, it will be a value 1, b value 1, c value 1 by root 2. Or if you can consider this also, then a value is root 2, b value is root 2, like that. Right? Anyone you can choose. Therefore, roots of quadratic equation. Quadratic equation are x is equal to minus p plus or minus square root of 4ac minus b square into a by 2a. See, here as it is for 3 marks, writing this formula is must and should. For example, if you done this calculations mistake also, for this formula, what you write x equal to minus p plus or minus square root of 4ac minus b square into I by 2a. For this formula, definitely there will be 1 mark. If you did not written this, for this question there will be only 2 marks, right? The formula is important, you need to write. Then x is equal to, substitute those values, minus b, so minus 1 plus or minus square root of 4ac. 4 into 1 into c is 1 by root 2 minus b square. B square value 1 into I by 2a. So here you need to simplify very carefully. Minus 1 plus or minus square root of c. 4 into 1 by root 2. 4 into 1 by root 2. How to simplify this? See, 4 we can write 2 into 2 divided by root 2. Again, 2 into. The 2 we can write as root 2 into root 2 by root 2. Why? Because root 2 into root 2 is nothing but 2 only. Now, root 2 cancel, what we will get? 2 root 2. Right? So, 4 into 1 by root 2 is nothing but 2 root 2. So, this is 2 root 2 minus 1 divided by 2 into a. What is a value? A value is 2. So, this is what the solution. Very easy questions to get 3 marks. Pause the video, note it down. Next, we will do miscellaneous examples from this chapter. By today's class and by tomorrow's class, we will complete the chapter of complex numbers and quadratic equations as per this PO board syllabus. Pause the video, note it down. Next, from miscellaneous examples, as I said, with respect to exercises, you need to give much importance to miscellaneous examples and exercise problems also. From that miscellaneous examples, that example starts from question number 12 and 13, and 14, 15, 16 also there. When it comes to question number 12, the question is find the conjugate of. What do you mean by conjugate? If complex number is in the form of a plus ib, conjugate of a plus ib is a minus ib. Just nothing but we need to put negative sign for imaginary part, not for real part. So, but is it in the form of a plus ib? No. First, what we need to do? Multiply these two. You will get a complex number in the numerator. If you multiply these two, again you will get a complex number in the denominator. Then what you need to do is rationalize with this denominator. For example, I am telling, see, 3 to 6, 3 3 is a 9i. Next, minus 2i into 2 is minus 4i. Minus into plus is minus 2 into 3 is 6. I into I is I square. I square value minus 1. So minus into minus plus divided by 1 into 2 is 2. 1 into minus I is minus I. 2I into 2 is 4I. Plus into minus is minus. 2 into 1 is 2. I into I is I square. I square value minus 1. So mine it will become plus. Then it will be 6 plus 6. This is 12 plus 5I divided by 2 plus 2, 4. 4i minus i is plus 3i. So if we simplify that, we got this. Then is it in the proper complex form, complex number form? No. Then what we do? We need to rationalize this. 4 minus 3i by 4 minus 3i. then I will be eliminated in the denominator. Then you have to separate the denominator to x and also to y. Then you will get complex number form. After getting complex number form, conjugate means you need to put negative sign for imaginary part. Nothing but to the y value. So that's about that question number 12. You need to simplify that. Next, from question number 13, find the modulus and argument of complex numbers. See, what do you mean by modulus? Modulus will represent with modulus of z or smaller. What is argument? Argument is nothing but theta, which is equal to argz. What do you mean by argz and what is mean by theta? Theta means any angle, it may be positive or negative. But when it comes to argument, argument means that theta should be greater than minus 180 degrees, less than or equal to 180 degrees. Remember this condition. So then we will consider as argument. We need to find from these two questions. So I will select this B question. So this one you need to solve. So this one is easy when compared to this. So that's why I selected this one. See, B is 1 by 1 plus I. We need to find modulus. To find modulus, what is modulus? This R formula, square root of x square plus y square. So what is x and y value here? So this is not in proper complex number form. Then what we need to do? Z is equal to 1 by 1 plus I into, we need to rationalize with this denominator. So 1 minus I by 1 minus I, which gives 1 minus I by 1 plus I into 1 minus I, like a plus ib into a minus ib, a square plus b square. So 1 square plus 1 square, which is 1 minus I by 2, which is equal to 1 by 2 plus I into minus 1 by 2. Then what is x value? X equal to 1 by 2, y is equal to minus 1 by 2. Now to find modulus, what is r value? Square root of x square plus y square, right? Square root of x square is 1 by 2 whole square is 1 by 4 plus y square minus 1 by 2 whole square is again 1 by 4. So which is LCM is same, 4, 1 plus 1, 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. So which means 1 by root 2 is what? Modulus. Next, when it comes to argument, argument tan theta is equal to y by x. What is y value? Minus 1 by 2. X value 1 by 2. So these two cancel, what will get? Minus 1. Tan theta is equal to minus tan pi by 4. Minus 1. Right? This is minus 1. Minus into 1. 1 is nothing but tan pi by 4. Right? See, if you identify this, is tan is, see, tan theta is equal to tan of minus pi by 4, can we write? My tan of minus pi by 4, can we write? We can write. Why? Because in trigonometry we have learned that tan theta, tan of minus theta is equal to tan theta, minus tan theta, right? Cos of minus theta is cos theta. Why? Because this is an even function, this is an odd function. Which are odd functions? Tan, sin. So those are all odd function. Odd function is tan of minus theta is minus tan theta. So minus tan theta you can write as tan of minus theta. But we should not consider this minus pi by 4 is our required argument. How to consider this is correct or not? According to complex number. What is complex number? X value positive, y value negative. X is positive, this side, x axis, y is negative, this side. So both combination is nothing but fourth quadrant. Fourth quadrant means angle should be minus theta. So that's what this is, right? So therefore, theta is equal to minus pi by 4. This is nothing but argument of z. So like this, we need to simplify the modulus and argument of a complex number if it is not in proper form. If it is in proper form, you can do very easily, right? R value substitute and theta value also you'll find. If it is not in the proper form, you need to simplify by using rationalizing the denominator, right? So pause the video to note it down. Next, we will solve another three questions we have. Question number 14. If you have textbook with you, note down that question without late. The question is, if x plus iy is equal to a plus ib by a minus ib. What is that? X plus iy is equal to, question number 14. If x plus iy is equal to a plus ib by a minus ib, then then show that or prove that x square plus y square is equal to 1. X square plus y square is equal to 1. What they given? If x plus iy is equal to a plus ib by a minus ib, we need to show that x square plus y square is equal to 1. See, if you observe this RHS, if it is in proper form like x plus iy, easily we can write x value and y value, we can substitute here. We should get 1. But since it is not in proper form, what we need to do? Rationalize the denominator. So let us simplify this. X plus iy is equal to a plus ib by a minus ib. So we need to rationalize with a plus ib by a plus ib. Why? Because here minus means we need to do with plus. So that one, a plus ib into a plus ib, what is that? A plus ib whole square. A plus ib whole square. This one, a plus ib into a minus ib, this is what? A square plus b square. So then what we got? X plus iy is equal to this one. So see, if you see this one, you can expand this way. A square plus a plus 2 whole square formula. A square plus ib whole square plus I into 2ab divided by a square plus b square. So this will be a square, ib whole square means b whole square means b square, I whole square is I square, I square value minus. So minus b square plus I into 2ab by a square plus b square. So this I will split it as a square minus b square by a square plus b square plus I into 2ab by a square plus b square, which is in the form of x plus iy, right? Therefore, what is x? X is equal to a square minus b square by a square plus b square. What was y? Y is equal to 2ab by a square plus b square. So now we got x value and y value. So in its proper form, so those two will substitute in this LHS, we will get that. So consider LHS. What is that LHS? X square plus y square. What is x square? A square minus b square by a square plus b square whole square plus y square. What is y? 2ab by a square plus b square whole square. So which is equal to, so simplify this, then what we should get is equal to 1. So definitely what we should get is equal to 1. See this one, a square minus b square whole square divided by a square plus b square whole square plus 2ab whole square divided by a square plus b square whole square. Now what is LCM, guys? LCM is same, a square plus b square whole square. Now we expand this. This a square you need to consider as a, b square you need to consider as b. So a minus b whole square form. So which will be a square whole square plus b square whole square minus 2a square b square, right? Now this one, this is plus 2 whole square is 4a square b square. So which is in the form of, so this is a square whole square plus b square whole square plus 4a square b square minus 2a square b square is 2a square b square divided by a square plus b square whole square, which results, see if you observe, this numerator is in the form of a plus b whole square, nothing but instead of a square is there, instead of b square is there. So this formula is a square plus b square whole square divided by a square plus b square whole square. These two will be simplified, which is equal to 1. So this is about the question x plus iy, this one. So this is very important for 3 marks. Right. So pause the video to note it down. Now last two questions of this miscellaneous examples. By these two questions we will end this session. But these two are very 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 important as per concept and also as per exam point of view. These two are very important questions. The questions are, find real theta such that this is purely real. Find real theta such that this is purely real. You know, in a complex number z is equal to x plus iy or a plus ib, If it is purely real, what is the condition? Purely real. See, in this z equal to x plus iy form, x is what? X is real part. Y is what? Imaginary part. Right? If they say purely real means what? Purely real means y equal to 0. That means only real part should be there. Iy shouldn't be there. Iy shouldn't be there means y should be equal to 0. Not iy should be equal to 0. Why? Because I is not equal to 0. If y is 0, 0 into anything, 0, only real part will be there. That is about condition for purely real. If they said in any question, they said purely imaginary. Purely imaginary means what we need to take condition is x should be equal to 0. If x is equal to 0, only iy will be there, then imaginary part only. So these are the conditions we need to remember this. Now, when it comes to the question, find real theta. Nothing but we need to find theta by using the condition purely real. Purely real means y equal to 0 condition. Say we consider let z is equal to 3 plus 2i sin theta divided by 1 minus 2i sin theta. See here, if it is in this form of x plus iy, directly we will make y equal to 0. But this is not in proper complex number form. Then what we need to do? Rationalize. 3 plus 2i sin theta divided by 1 minus 2i sin theta. Then we need to rationalize with 1 plus 2i sin theta divided by 1 plus 2i sin theta. See, if we multiply this numerators, 3 into 1 is 3 plus 3 into 2i is i into 6 sin theta. Right? 2, 3, 3 to 6. Next, 2i into 1 is i into 2 sin theta plus 2 into 2, 4. I into I square value is minus sin theta into sin theta is sin square theta. Whole divided by. So 1 minus nothing but a minus ib into a plus ib, which is a square plus b square. What is a square? 1 square plus b square is 2 sin theta whole square. Simplify this. This is 3 minus 4 sin square theta. 3 minus 4 sin square theta, nothing but real parts, plus in these, if we take I common, 6 sin theta plus 2 sin theta, which is 8 sin theta, divided by, this is what, 1 square, 1 plus 2 square, this is 4 sin square theta. Now, this one, if we denominator, if we split, definitely we will get x plus iy form. So, which is 3 minus 4 sin square theta by 1 plus 4 sin square theta plus I into 8 sin theta by 1 plus 4 sin square theta. If you observe, this is in the form of x plus iy, right? X plus iy. As the complex number is, what they said, condition? Purely real. As it is purely real, what will be the condition? Y equal to 0. Y equal to 0. What is y here? 8 sin theta by 1 plus 4 sin square theta equal to 0. That means 8 sin theta equal to 0. Because the denominator is sent to right hand side, then 8 sin theta equal to 0. Is if 8 sin theta equal to 0, 8 sin theta is equal to 0. What is sin theta? 0 by 8, nothing but sin theta is equal to what? Again 0. Now, if sin theta equal to 0, what may be the theta? We know according to the trigonometric equations. If sin theta equal to 0, what is theta? Theta equal to n pi where n belongs to z. See, now you can remember one point. While solving any math problems, there will be multiple concepts. See here, in the sin theta equal to 0, we have introduced trigonometric functions, and also in this chapter, complex numbers and quadratic equations, both we will mix, and so these are all concepts comes under trigonometry. So while we are doing any chapter of a trigonometry or any chapter of this maths, there will be related concepts to the previous concept. So we need to thorough all the concepts of previous lessons and chapters. So this is about this question. Find real theta when it is purely real. Purely real means only one simple condition, y you need to equate to 0. If this is purely imaginary, then what you need to do? X you need to equate to 0. Then you get. Now, when it comes to last question of this session, this is very much important when compared to all the questions in the miscellaneous examples. The question is, convert the complex number in polar form. As I said, converting complex number into polar form is 1-3 marks question. Another one is finding roots of quadratic equation. When it comes to this first quota, converting complex number into polar form, they may ask this question also from miscellaneous examples. So that's why you need to give much importance to this question. The question is, given z is equal to I minus 1 by cos pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 2. See, we need to convert into polar form, right? Polar form means what? R into cos theta plus I sin theta. This is nothing but z is equal to. We need to find R value and theta. We need to substitute here. But to find R value, we need to find x square and y square, right? But here, I, x and y, we cannot identify from this. So what we need to do is, we need to simplify this. So this is I minus 1 by cos pi by 3, nothing but cos 60 is 1 by 2 plus I into sin 60 is root 3 by 2. So here LCM will be 2, right? LCM will be 2. That 2 I will send to numerator. 2 into I minus 1 divided by 1 plus I root 3. Did it converted into complex form? Complex number form? No. Why? Because again I is in denominator. Then what we need to do? Z is equal to 2 into I minus 1 by 1 plus I root 3 into 1 minus I root 3 by 1 minus I root 3. So I need to rationalize. So then it will be, you multiply 2 into I into 1 is I into I is I square. I square is minus 1. Minus in 1 into minus is plus root 3. Next, minus 1 into 1 is minus 1. Minus into minus is plus I root 3 divided by 1 plus I root 3 into 1 minus I root 3. 1 square plus root 3 whole square. So which will be 2 into root 3 minus 1 plus, if you take I common, again this is root 3 plus 1 divided by 1 plus root 3 whole square is 3. 3 plus 1 is nothing but 4. Then it will be 2 ones, 2 twos. Then it will be root 3 minus 1 by 2 plus I into root 3 plus 1 by 2. So this is what? Z, which is in the form of x plus iy. Therefore, what is x? X is equal to root 3 minus 1 by 2. What is y? Y is equal to root 3 plus 1 by 2. So there, if we know x and y values, you can find r nothing but modulus, which is formula x square plus y square. You substitute x value and y value, square root of root 3 minus 1 by 2 whole square plus y square is root 3 plus 1 by 2 whole square. Simplify color that. Root 3 minus 1 whole square is, root 3 whole square is 3 plus 1 square is 1 minus 2 root 3 plus root 3 plus 1 whole square is, root 3 whole square is 3 plus 1 plus 2 root 3 whole divided by 4, right, which is equal to, here minus 2 root 3 plus 2 root 3 cancel, 3 plus 3 6, 1 plus 1 2, 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 by 4 is nothing but 2, so which means the value of that is root 2, right, 8 by 4 is 2, so value of that r is root 2, nothing but modulus value root 2. Next we need to find theta, right? Theta is nothing but argument we need to find. After that, the theta and modulus value we need to substitute in terms of polar form. That's it. Now to find theta value, which trigonometric function we can use? We need to use sin theta and cos theta, or instead of using those two, we can simply use tan theta also. Tan theta is equal to y by x. What is y value we got? Root 3 plus 1 by 2 divided by root 3 minus 1 by 2. If we simplify this, 2 2 cancel, we got root 3 plus 1 by root 3 minus 1. If we simplify this, root 3 plus 1 by, again root 3 plus 1, rationalize that. So root 3 plus 1 into root 3 plus 1 is root 3 plus 1 whole square divided by a plus b into a minus b which is a square minus b square. So simplify this, root 3 whole square is 3 plus 1 plus 2 root 3 divided by 3 minus 1 is 2. So which will be 4 plus 2 root 3 by 2. If you take 2 common numerator, 2 plus root 3 by 2. That means what we got is tan theta is equal to 2 plus root 3 we got. Did you remember this 2 plus root 3 value? You need to remember that tan theta is equal to, this is tan 75 degrees. You have find it now. Tan 75 value is nothing but 2 plus root 3. But in arguments we need to write in terms of radians, right? So 75 in terms of radians is pi by 180. 515, 536, next 35 and 312. So which means pi pi by 12. So tan theta is equal to what? Tan 5 pi by 12. Now is this pi pi by 12 is correct or not? How to check? How to check? Based on x and y values. If you observe that x and y values, x is also positive, y is also positive. Positive positive means first quadrant. First quadrant is theta. Theta is nothing but in between 0 to 90 degrees. The value also we got 75 degrees. So it is correct. Therefore, our required polar form is z is equal to r into what is r? Root t into cos theta, which is cos 5 pi by 12 plus I into sin 5 pi by 12. So this is our required answer, right? So this is about today's class. Hope you all understood the classes, which is based on quadratic equations and also converting complex number into polar form. Thank you for watching. Thank you. Have a nice day. Keep learning.